Hi guys, what's up? Jeremy Schaefer here. So a quick update on my wrist, which many of you know I injured. I broke it a couple months ago falling off my flaming unicycle. Got it x-rayed a couple days ago and came back that the bones are fusing together nicely, so that's cool. Let's celebrate. I'm going to show you how to fold something out of Wyndstone. Well, this is a 20-inch sheet of Wyndstone, and I'm going to teach you how to fold my butterfly crane. You see, it's a crane, but on the back, it's a butterfly. And if you look closely, it's not just a butterfly crane. It's a bulldog butterfly crane. All right, you want to learn it? Here it goes. The bulldog butterfly crane. And it starts out from a sheet of paper that's the same color on both sides. I'm using a sheet of Wyndstone. It's about 20 inches to a side. Fold this edge up like this. We're folding the bird base. And open up and flatten. All right, now we're gonna fold the bird base, but instead of folding it to the crease like this, we're gonna fold about a few millimeters away from it, like this. And same thing on all of the flaps. Alright, and fold the top, or now it's the bottom, fold it up. And fold this corner to the crease. And one more time right to the crease. Okay, now we have to sink this point, open sink it, so open up the whole paper, and we're just gonna, I have one hand underneath, and we're gonna go around this square, sinking it. This is called an open sink. Alright, now push the middle in, like this, as you close it back up. And now we're going to take this flap and we're gonna put it down this way, and this flap goes down like this. And we fold this down here, and same thing on this side. Folds down like that. And now we're gonna zoom in. Okay, on this side, we're gonna make a valley fold that goes from this corner to right here. And do that on this side too. Now, on the other side, right here, we're going to fold between here and here, and it's a valley fold on all layers. And the only reason why we're doing it on all layers is so that we get a pre-creased valley. You see, when you unfold it, then you can reach in the middle here, and this is a valley fold. That's what we want it. And so we're just gonna fold this layer like that. And we're going to fold this layer to the inside, but it's now a valley fold. We want it to be a mountain fold, so might as well turn it over and fold it over the whole thing, all layers. And now it's a mountain fold, and just tuck it inside. All right, now let's do the petal fold. Lift up the flap. And petal fold on the other side. I want to fold this down first to make it a little bit easier. Now, on this side where we had the valley fold here, that's the right side, we're going to do that crane fold where you fold the edge to the middle. And we're going to fold it not to the raw edge, but we're going to fold it all the way to the folded edge. And I'm going to show you in just a second what I mean. See? It goes right to the middle, not to this edge, but to that edge. Okay. And turn it over and do the same thing. And now we're going to fold this edge to the same place. It's going to get a little bit thick here, so. And this fold doesn't need to come all the way to the corner. In fact, it really shouldn't. You should think about how big you're going to make the head of the crane. And if it's about that big, then that's where it should go to. Okay, same thing on the other side. And let's do the reverse fold right now. Let's get this crane head out of the way. So, reverse fold as you would a normal crane. Just like this. And reverse fold the head. Right like this. And there's the very skinny crane head. More like a snake head, but whatever. Okay. Now we're gonna do a reverse fold here. And this reverse fold should come out horizontal so that this edge lines with this crease. And just to make sure that our crane works so far, let's fold from right here to right here. Fold the flap down like you would a normal crane. And same thing on this side. Okay, and let's see if it works. So holding here, we're not done yet. I'm just testing the action. So you want to pull down. Oh, this is some serious paper here. Okay, so yes, the crane is working. That's good. But we're not done yet. So fold it back up like this. And we're going to fold this edge up. Actually, we're going to trisect this angle right here, or just roughly. It doesn't need to be perfect. But that means we're going to make a valley and then fold it down again. And yeah, just try to make it as close to trisection as possible. Same thing on the other side. You can match it with the edge below if you did a different trisection. All right, now we're going to turn these folds that we just unfolded and make them as reverse folds. So this is going to go like this, and you're going to have to form a new fold that goes from here to here so that it's a reverse fold. And same thing, one more time, fold this down and continue it to right here. So we're folding this edge here as a reverse fold. And we're going to do the same thing on this side. Now let's see if it still works. Yeah. Okay. Hopefully it will still work and it hasn't ripped there. Okay. Now we're going to do the last step, which is the butterfly. So what we're going to do is we're going to mark this corner. We're going to make a pleat that originates right at that top here. You see? Gonna have a valley fold. Maybe from here it's easier. Let's start with the mountain fold. The mountain fold is gonna go from here to there. How do you know the exact guideline? Well, if you fold this corner down, then you can kind of get a good guideline. Just fold the mountain like that. And then pleat it about like that. It doesn't really matter how much, that's really to taste, however you like the butterfly to look. And that's the wing. To make it a little bit more shapely, we're going to do this little fun fold where it's a swivel fold. We're folding this edge to that edge. And then at the same time, let me get a little bit closer so you can see this, folding this edge over and flatten. You see how that changes the shape a little bit? Makes more of a groove there. And and we're gonna do this whole thing on the other side. So this marks the point here, and do I really need to do this again? Okay, why not? And notice how these folds originate right at that point there. They're not down here, they're just up here. And make the groove. Okay. And hopefully it will still flap. See? This is where it could really rip, so you have to just do this very slowly. Okay, still good. Yeah, out of commie paper, that might rip it. If it rips, well, there's always tape. But this is some pretty tough Wyndstone, so it doesn't tear as easily, which is good. All right, one more step. We are going to reverse fold this flap. It's actually a couple more steps. Okay, fold it down. We're reverse folding it right at that corner right there. And now what we're gonna do is take this flap right here and just tuck it right underneath. Same thing over here, just tuck it underneath. And now unreverse it, unreverse the tail so it comes up like this. See, we actually still have something going on here, which is okay. And now unfold this flap. And we're going to reverse this crease so this flap goes inside. That, and on this side, same thing. So here's the flap, we just unfold it. Reversing the crease. If it still works. It does. Ooh, I love Wyndstone. Okay. Now, so here is the butterfly crane. You could just stop there, but what else does it look like? See how it looks like a bulldog? Well, we're gonna make it a little bit more like a bulldog. So just shape this so that it looks like an eye. A Yoshizawa type style eye. Same thing over here, we're just curving it a little bit. And make it look really like a bulldog. Hold the ear down. So here you have your crane from here at this side, and you have a butterfly right here, and you also have a bulldog, and when you pull the tail, it talks, it barks. Well, maybe not. There it is, the butterfly crane. Well, hope you like this video, and please subscribe to Jeremy Schaefer Origami. And my hand's getting a little bit better. See, I'm not using the brace, but that was kind of some rough folding. Anyway, have a good one. See you later.